Welcome back to Tools and Track. After the last episode in this, that was an absolute fiasco, tonight we are actually going to achieve something.
So, quick point of authority here on Tools and Track. This is episode 50 of the Locost.
Woohoo!
And now that we have done 50 episodes, we've started to develop a bit of a little culture on this channel. I've got a massive amount of people now following me. I've got a massive amount of Patreons now supporting me. And if, like me, you watch many other YouTube channels, you're probably aware that adverts are literally sucking the life out of all of this. I'm no better if I do it as well, so I've turned them off. I'm going to just purely build this on Patreon support, because let's be honest, it's actually more supportive than Google Ads ever will be, especially due to the size of this channel. So they're off. If you really feel that that benefits you and want to say thanks, patreon.com/toolsandtrack, because so long as there's a Patreon, there will not be ads in this. Right, on with it. Now that we've got the brake calipers in the rear on the right sides, it's been a long process. We can look at the handbrake cables because that's a bit more representative, you know, when they're on right. So what I've done is this. So I've taken the bracket off because, well, I think that's the other side bracket, which I thought might kind of save me, but it doesn't. So this is the bracket that it should have, and that puts the cable there. Now you can see at the angle that's going to sit at, if I pull it round, it's thoroughly fouling on the body. It's just, frankly, not right. It's not going to work like that. So what I'm thinking, in typical Tools and Track fashion, is we just make a new bracket. So I think, looking at the range of motion that this lever for the brake caliper has, it still needs to be able to pull all around there, but it's not particularly hard to get that motion from there. So if we just push the bracket out to sit about there, it'll work. The only problem with that is, if we were to use this bracket or this design, this guy would need to be twice as long and that guy would be slightly shorter and it'd have no strength. So, gussets anyone? Okay, a small point of order. As you probably guessed, at some point I'm going to have to get a haircut. Now, I've not been the best at continuity the best of times, and you may think, well, that's fine, at the end of this episode, his hair might be shorter. What's probably not evident is I'm filming about 3 episodes at once at the moment. So, what's going to happen is my hair will get short, and then over the next few episodes, it'll get long, and then short, and then long in another episode, and then short again. So, this does not mean that I am some freak hairy monster that can grow his hair to this length every week and then shorten it again. I'm just crap at making sure I get a haircut more than twice a year. Now that we've settled that, let's get back into it. We'll be right back.
haircut. Right, so it's been a couple of days, clearly, and we've set out to get some wins in this because I'm frankly sick of not getting any. So, pedal box painted, fitted, vinyl fitted, so that's it and not going to move. And I've got to say, the grip tape on the pedals, which was an old skateboarder hack for about £2, will completely pass that IV requirement of non-slip pedals. Actually looks quite natty in race car as well, so I'm into that. Now we'll need to look at getting a master cylinder back in that and start laying out the front brake lines. And for that, we have some longer lines. Well, they are now definitely going to be long enough. If we'd give them the wee clink down there, they're going to run to where I want them to run, so that's good. Now you'll see I've once again changed my mind and proposed putting this guy here, which probably wouldn't fail much and be okay, but as time goes by, I'm reminded more and more of some of the issues I'm going to face when I add more things. And one such thing is body panel. Kind of inclined not to have this running through its own specific little body panel hole, so I think what we're going to do is have it running the lower arm of the wishbone and its dedicated wee hole. So, if I was to do that, it makes sense to have this here, above that, so that it will port into something that's out the way of all of the kerfuffle. Same goes for that side, but it's still neat and quite strengthy. So, let's go with that. So I'm thinking something like that. Obviously we can orientate and trim and mess with this as much as we want. But I think if I put a wee bracket here that pins that, in some way, shape or form. Let's it run down. Probably gonna have to put a second one here just to stop it contacting the lower part of the coil over mount. This still does the thing, happily. And we don't have any contacty fun. And last of all,
we don't have any dramas on deflection either. No matter how high you want to go, chances of us getting that high on track, I would say pretty low, but still, not a with realms of possibility. And the last thing I'd want to happen if I did manage to make this level of failure happen is have my brakes go. So, that I think is going to be our solution. Let's piss around no further and make it work.
Oh, feels good to finally make a decision on something. Yeah, made another executive decision. So I know we'll put the brackets on and was about to start the fronts. However, the little splitting valve for the HEL lines that I bought didn't really seem like it wanted to go anywhere in the front. I wasn't really happy with it. So I think we'll get just a normal brass T-piece for that. And I've put it in the back. So we now have a neat little line running from there all the way under the transmission tunnel. And yes, temporary. These will be changed, but you know, it holds it in place for the moment so that I can fabricate up the back. So that's kind of where we're at. Now I know that's quite an aggressive protrusion, so we'll just kind of suck it and see if it needs a bit of fettling. There's enough slack in it should it fill with a diff. So the next stage, obviously, is running the hard lines from there to each of the rear brake calipers. Now I've had a wee look at this, and the rear lines, quite simply, go here with the wee brackets, like so, and foul on nothing. So that's what we're going to do.
Yeah. Orange was always going to be the colour. I just thought I'd buy new ones, put an actual aerosol orange on, and the finish would be a lot better. No shit, it's a lot better. So, right now, I'm just waiting on paint for the handbrake brackets drying. Then we'll throw them on, and then we'll see if we can finish these brake lines. I'll be honest, right now, I'm actually still waiting for that fecking copper T-piece for the front, because I've ordered one literally 10 days ago, and eBay sellers are eBay sellers. Anyway, right, we're going to go do a quick time hop. I'm going to come back with a copper thing. We'll finish the front lines, and that'll do it, eh? That'll do it. Aye. Yeah, we'll come back to this handbrake fiasco the next episode, I think. Because I still don't know what I'm going to do with that. In other news, tech screws are very handy for putting these P-clips in. What do we think? A nice enough permanent solution? What do you think? Am I actually going to leave that in? Nah, I mean, they look pro enough. But there's something about a self-tapper that's just a bit, I don't know. So I think we'll revisit that. It'll do the now, it'll hold it in the now, but I don't know. Hit me up in the comments, would you consider that permanent or would that not be right? Don't know. Brakes are done. Well, kind of. There's some terms and conditions with this, but I think we're in a good place with them. So let's run through my still kind of debating to-do list, starting with the following, which I'm sure most of you engineering types have been watching me put in and have been cringing about. The tech screw. So my thoughts with this, it's quick, it's simple, it's pretty secure, especially for a brake line, but it is, at the end of the day, still a self-tapper, and I'm not really convinced that's what the chassis needs. So we might come back and either rev nut or find some more permanent solution to that. But for the moment, they'll hold it in place, and whatever that solution is going to be, I've already drilled a hole for it, so it's just gonna be a case of widening it out and dealing with it. Second on the list, the front arm securing points. So that's gonna need my brain to go away for a few weeks and go, I wonder what we'll do about that. But we'll find something that's a bit more permanent that'll hold those lines in place so they don't flop around. But for the moment, for the sakes of presentation and fanning around, they'll do the job with a wee cable tie. Next up, the handbrake. Yeah, be under no illusion, that's going to probably form the next episode, because whilst I thought putting those changey brackets on might slacken it up, they've done exactly the opposite. They need more room because of the wider angle that they're going to operate on. So that is absolutely out of the equation. We're going to have to modify. Also on the list, the pitiful brake discs. Yeah, that's me just not doing the thing and researching. What I've done there is order whatever the smaller, crapper version of those brake discs are, and then put them on and obviously failed. I can have two options here. I can either run with this guy, which is the smaller carrier and will make those brake discs work, but that would mean finding a carrier for the near side, which I don't have, and I'm going to be honest, it was a total fluke that I got the offside with a carrier. I've never been able to find the near side. I'm not against this idea though, because overbraking the rear on a car that's going to be much lighter than an MX-5, probably not a good idea. So getting a smaller brake disc, it's not the end of the world. The other option is going to be dealing with the spare carrier, which will actually resolve the problem because the calipers themselves will fit on either carrier. It's just the carrier itself that stands off a bit more for the larger discs. So if we go with that route, we just need to get the discs that will match. So, it's probably going to be the simpler for the sake of actually finding the parts, but, well, yeah, I'll come back to it again. Need to go do the thinky thing. So, that kind of wraps up all of the to-do list. Other than that, brakes, mate, we smashed it, completed it, pal. So, the next thing we're going to have to think about, and this is where I need your guys' help, is wheels. Because the brakes now being on mean that we can start looking to put this chassis rolling again, and I need to do that for one critical reason. Well, we've done the lights and the brakes. The last thing to deal with in the front end is actually the wheel guards. So, in order to do that, I have 17-inch wheels at the moment, which are far too big, and I'm not going to use them. What I'd like is, I say, a 15x7 to 15x8, pretty dishy numbers, something that's going to suit the car, look quite aggressive, look quite tracky, 4x100 fit. If that is something you have lying around in your garage and you want rid of, hit me up. I'm open to water style, I'm open to mini lake style, I'm open to anything. Drop me a link, drop me a message. Just now, I'm not saying I've got unlimited budget, but yeah, I know that wheels aren't cheap these days, but I need them. So if you've got wheels, let me know. Once the wheels are on, I've got tires, so we can then actually move to a rolling chassis and start doing the sides. The sides that we've already done, yes, but now that I've got all the bits that need to poke through, we can put them on for good. And then we can start looking to properly build this up for the last time. So I'm assuming you'll be as excited about that as I am, so make sure you've got that like, subscribe and all that other jazz button hit, because more content will be coming soon. If you want to support a bit more than that, patreon.com/toolsandtrack, because remember, that is clearing the way for there to be no ads on this channel ever again, because they're horrific. You're welcome. Anyway, that'll do for now. Thanks for watching, guys. Thanks for sticking with it for this amount of time. We're getting there, and I will see you next week. Until then, drive safe. Oh yeah, and I will clean this, I promise.